Here we will find out who is responsible for conducting component testing. Let's start by talking about the developer. In most companies, the developer who has written the code is also responsible for performing the component testing. But in some organizations, the testing is done by the tester. But if the tester does it, then he requires a code. So if developer is performing the test, then he's using his own code. But if the tester is performing it, then he requires a code from a developer. Anyway, in most organizations, this testing is performed by the developer. Now, what are the steps involved in component testing? First, we write the code. Then we execute the code. This lets us find defects. Once we find the defects, we fix them. And then we'll execute the code again. We will continue this cycle until no more defects are found. This is one way to do the testing. There is also a different approach. It is called test-driven development, TDD. Under TDD, first we do a test, then we write the code. So, first we do a testing activity, then we do a development activity. In the other approach, we wrote the code first. This is the complete opposite of that. Remember that test-driven development is a highly iterative method. The first thing we will do is automate the test scripts. We start with writing the test scripts. This is a testing activity. After that, we will integrate and build the code. Once the code is written, we will execute it with the script. So, first the test script is written from the specifications by the tester, while the code is written from the same specifications by the developer. This is written by the tester, and this is written by the developer. Once they are both ready, we will execute them together. Once we do this, we may find a defect, and we will need to correct it. Then, we will again start from this first step. If the script needs to be updated, then we will do that. If the code needs to be changed, then we will do that. After that, we will execute them all over again. We will keep on repeating this process until the test script matches the code. So this was the alternate method of testing, and it is called test-driven development. That is all from this video. See you in the next one. Happy testing.